Do you find the defendant guilty or not guilty?
The ultimate sin.
He beat her.
A young girl violated and stripped of her dignity.
You have a right to stand up for yourself. Who's going to believe it?
I don't think she really knows what's going to happen if she goes through with this.
The truth is silenced by fear.
I'm scared.
She lied because she was afraid.
Caught in a web of deceit, Lindsay Wagner risks everything to bring justice in the network premiere, Sins of Silence, tonight at 9 on 5.
1998 comes in with a bang as storms and tornadoes batter Britain. The South Coast.
You need a holiday, the one you've always promised yourself. Starting tomorrow, the Daily Mail begins its biggest holiday giveaway ever, with hundreds of prizes. You could enjoy a fabulous dream holiday on the world's finest beaches, absolutely free. Plus, there's a fantastic £50 holiday voucher, free for every reader. Don't miss your free £50 holiday voucher. All you have to do is pick up the Daily Mail tomorrow.
The Sainsbury's reward card has more fun things for you to enjoy than any of the others.
Want to be in the movies?
Just two Sainsbury's reward vouchers get two people into a film.
It's easy to convert Sainsbury's reward vouchers into air miles for treats you and your family will really enjoy.
Three vouchers get you one free adult admission to a theme park.
And it's easier to earn vouchers because Sainsbury's gives you more extra reward points than any other supermarket.
When you're driving the new Toyota Avensis, you can just sit back and enjoy the ride.
This train does not stop at all.
Rugby Express, the week's best rugby union, Sunday at 6 on 5.
Gotham, a city with an evil underbelly.
Freeze!
Plagued by crime.
Decent people shouldn't live here.
And only one man can save it.
I like him already.
Our caped crusader. Jack Nicholson.
Wait till they get a load of me.
Michael Keaton.
I'm Batman.
And Kim Basinger. Starring Batman, Monday at 8:30 on 5.
Now, a little bit rude, a little bit crude, but lots of laughs, Q Graham.
To a brand new series of Bring Me the Head of Light Entertainment, the comedy panel game that attracts laughter like bees round a magnet. Now, before we start the show, I have a very special announcement for tonight.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thanks to the trained voices there of Norwich Lesbian Choir. We're going to reveal the true meaning of life. We are. Actually, it was meant to be a competition to win a Teletubby doll, but we couldn't find a Teletubby, so the meaning of life it is. Our regular team captains are two fine young comedians who promise three things. Laughter, laughter, and laughter, and to repair my auto-cue. They are Dominic Holland! Joining Dominic is a Scottish comedian who tells us she really wants to put her hometown of Musselboro on the map, somewhere off the coast of Norway. She is Rhona Cameron! And alongside Paul is another fine stand-up comedian who first performed at his cousin's wedding. Luckily, his cousin didn't catch him. He is Junior Simpson! Right, let the games commence. And for each one we play, there's a total of 5 points to be won. We start with the what not to say round, where the team suggests the most inappropriate responses to certain situations. Okay, everyone, what should one, under no circumstances, say in the following situations? When being shown around the newly restored Windsor Castle by the Queen.
Can we smoke?
This room would benefit from an open fireplace.
You should have gone for the stone cladding.
So, you and Phil, you're like still sleeping in the same bed and everything.
Your Majesty, is this Prince Edward's closet?
Oh, she'd laugh. What should you say to the cabinet minister whose son was accused of selling cannabis?
Don't worry about it, mate. Let's go back to my place and skin up.
Jack, if I could just have an eighth of your time.
Very good.
How about, are you going to change your name from Jack Straw to Jack Grass now, then?
What not to say when answering the door to some Jehovah's Witnesses?
Come in.
What blood group are you?
We've time for one more. Okay. What not to say on picking up a date from their parents' house?
Does this sofa stain easily?
I won't drink drive. It infringes my parole.
Yes, this is my 100th potential shot. I didn't forget. Yes, this is my 100th potential. Yes, this is my 100th potential shag, and it's for the second week in January.
Yeah, Rhona Cameron, funniest woman alive.
You see, Rhona, I understood everything you were saying just a little bit.
So I tell you, just for speaking, be able to speak, I'm going to give Rhona and Dominic 2 points. Which means 3 points! 3 points, Junior and Paul! Time now to test our team's acting skills with a round called Shopping Lists. You know, the concept of shopping has changed so much since I was a lad. You know, gone are the days when you could nip down to the corner shop with tuppence halfpenny and come out with a quarter of barley twists, 2 dozen Mars bars, a pocket full of yo-yos, and a portable radio. See, shoplifting just isn't what it used to be, is it? Now, in this round, our teams will take it in turns to be shopkeepers and customers. Oh! Dominic's team will be starting this one. Dominic is the customer. You're the customer. I'd like Rhona, find it. Imagine you run a stationer shop. And to help Rhona get into the part, if you just find down there, you've got a bit of stationer, stationer's
why,
coat.
Please. Here is some stationer's clothing.
Stationer's coat and a pencil. So get that
stand
on.
Up.
Now, Dominic has come to Rhona's shop with a list of stationery to buy. Yep. There it is. Yep. There's
this,
a list.
Is this my pen?
That's your pencil, that's your chair.
It's good, this, isn't it?
Dominic's job is to get Rhona to say as many items on his shopping list as he can. The catch is, he's not allowed to mention any of them by name. It'll become clear as it goes on. I'll be judging them on the number of items identified and how convincing their scene is.
Okay.
His list will be appearing on your screen. Okay, Dominic and Rhona, your time starts now.
Good afternoon. I'm very unhappy. I've got the measure of this shop, I'm telling you. I mean, what are you trying to do, shatter my nerves? Because I'm shatterproof, let me tell you that now.
Are you?
I'm shatterproof.
That's good. Shatterproof.
I want to speak to the big cheese, the guy in charge of the entire chain, the guy who runs the entire...
You must want the ruler, sir.
And let me start by saying, before I complain, I want to say I'm absolutely in favour of farm equipment. Completely.
Are
in
you?
I am. I'm not anti, I am for. another word for four, and basic farm vehicle.
Tractor, you want a protractor?
Yes! OK, hurry up,
you might think I'm drunk. You might think I'm drunk, but last night, I had one drink last night, and I tell you, I actually felt tipsy. Felt tipsy.
Felt tipsy, you want
Thank
felt
you.
Tips.
No, you just said that! That's not how the game works. I felt tips. That makes all the difference. Next one,
okay, there's a queue, madam. I'm in the queue. Oh, you work here? Okay, come pass.
Compass.
Yeah.
Shameless cheating now. Come on, one last one.
What's your name? What is your name? Bye, Rhona.
Bye, Rhona. Right, your turn now, Paul and Junior. I'd like Junior to imagine he runs a baker's shop using those baker's props you'll find there. Slip into those.
Oh, yeah, Paul, because these are very, very popular with the brothers now, wearing these kind of things. You can see, there's... Yeah, and it... Ooh. Fits me lovely.
Oh, weeks of fittings. Paul, you're the customer, and here's your shopping list. Okay. Now, you know the rules. Basically, they broke the rules.
Okay. What do you want? You're coming to the shop at this time of night. I got things to do, you know? All right, come on.
The time starts now.
Okay, how are you?
I've wondered
what Huggy Bear did since Starsky and Hutch. I'm looking for those sticky jam things. Always remind me of the Spice Girls.
Tart. Do you want another tart?
Do you like the Spice Girls or?
No, I can't stand them.
You can't stand. Like, Posh Spice. She's quite well. She got the call that because she's quite well. Good upbringing.
She's stiff.
Very well brought up.
Vomit. What?
Mother's pride.
Bread. Oh!
It's a miracle.
But of course, they only call her that because her dad drives around in a
van.
Big.
Posh car.
Big posh car with a big naked woman on the front with wings.
Oh, she has some rolls.
Sporty Spice just dresses like one of those caring the community people, so she's probably as nutty as a
fruitcake.
Excellent. I'll tell you what I want. I really, really want.
Unbelievable. We were there. We could smell the bread cooking.
Sorry, that was just me.
Yeah. you lot.
Right.
There was cheating and Rhona was wearing makeup. I couldn't believe she worked in a stationer's shop.
I felt held back in my costume.
Blame it if you will, you're getting 1 point. Which means four triumphant points to Paul and Junior. Which means that at the end of round two, Dominic and Rhona have 3 points, but Paul and Junior have 7! For our next round, I'll be looking for a willing volunteer from our lovely audience. So, come with me now as I float amongst them like a mayfly on gossamer wings. Well, all right, waddle there like a fat puff. Anyway, off I go. Waddle down. Got a lovely microphone so I can speak to the people. Look at me, bursting in amongst you. Hello, sir.
Hello there.
You're all right. Noel's house party's off the air. You must be so sad. who else? Now, I have to say, glitter top does appeal. It's show business, isn't it? You wanted to be on the show, didn't you? You wore a special show business top. What's your name?
Jackie.
Do you want to be on the show?
Yeah, sure.
You do, don't you? She's not shy, is she, sir? You won't be together long, I'm guessing. To find out just what lovely surprises await Lucky Jackie here, join us after this brief intermission. Come with me, Jackie. Come on.
Safety is something no vehicle manufacturer can ignore. because you just can't trust other road users.
The Dolland & Acheson half-price sale is now on.
Perfect.
This Saturday, I'm going to spend 20p on a
thoroughbred racehorse,
which is then chopped up, very small, pan-fried,
and sprinkled all over the roses.
I'm going to open a case of 20-year-old lager.
Then go swimming.
In a rich cream and white wine sauce.
I'm going to cruise down the high street.
In a black leather basque.
And a jockstrap.
I'm going to go clubbing.
Baby giraffes.
With a 7-iron.
However you spend Saturday, spend 20p on the new Saturday Times.
If you suffered the pain of mild arthritis, nothing you can buy is more effective than Feldene P. Feldene P pinpoints and penetrates to power away the pain of mild arthritis. Nothing you can buy is more effective.
Domestos Power Cleaner banishes even tough cooking stains. Because it's from Domestos, it has more power to clean, and it does even more. It kills kitchen germs as well. Good to know, isn't it?
Don't miss Britain's biggest kitchen and bedroom sale with up to 50% off at MFI Homeworks. But hurry, some offers must end on January the 11th.
Now from shredded wheat comes new Honey Nut Shredded Wheat. Golden honey and toasted nuts over shredded wheat bites. To say the least, they're Moorish. In fact, they're so Moorish, you'll soon find an open box is an empty box with new Honey Nut Shredded Wheat.
If vehicles have any long-term future, they must be made as fuel-efficient as possible. Of course, some are much further down that road than others.
Hello again. You join us at the start of a round called Don't Make Me Laugh, where the object is not to get laughs. Now, I know what you're thinking. If you don't want to get laughs from a show, why don't you just put the words Christmas special after the title? Now, our teams will now compete to make a single member of our audience laugh. And tonight's lucky member is the delightful Jackie. Jackie, we stroke you. Jackie, where do you live?
In Norwich.
You live in Norwich. And the lovely boyfriend creature now, what's his name?
Greg.
Greg. And is he from Norwich as well?
No, he's from France.
From France, you say? Hello. But look how chic Greg is, wearing orange with orange. He's no fool. Now, what Jackie's done, Jackie's chosen a card on which is printed a punchline. And tonight's punchline is...
You must be joking.
And Jackie's mission is to respond to anything the team say to her with that punchline. You must be joking, OK? But the object is to remain stony-faced throughout.
Right.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, there's your punchline. Teams, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, fire away.
Do you know that women don't find me attractive?
You must be joking.
Did you know that white men can dance?
You must be joking.
You know there's over 3 million people watching this program?
You must be joking.
Yeah, I am.
Okay.
Scotland 10, Brazil 0.
You must be joking.
Yeah. Here's one, Jackie. My name was Joe Smith, but then I married a Mr. King.
You must be joking.
Let's make a round of applause.
Do you know that Michael Jackson looks like his parents?
You must be joking.
It was.
No, Jackie, I swear I was in the same room, Graham Norton, three women and a cattle prog.
I find the French really good lovers.
Ooh, that was heartfelt. Is he crap, Jackie, is he?
Get it on.
He spends all his time buying jackets and shirts, doesn't he? Pays no attention to you.
William Higgs, a happily married heterosexual man.
These three blokes went into a pub, right?
You must be joking.
See, it's the beginning of a joke.
Yeah.
So you must be joking, leading off from that, it's quite funny.
It's not. But it was worth a try.
I thought it was quite good.
Did you?
Jackie didn't guess it.
No.
Try the French. Trois hommes en tout. I want you to score this round. You understand you've got 5 points to distribute as you will. How many points are you going to give to Paul and Junior there?
I'll give them 2 points.
2 points?
Cheers.
And so that means you're going to give them three. Why did you like them more?
I think they gave me more...
joy.
They gave you more to work with. Oh, listen, you liked them, we liked you. Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Jackie! We move on now to a round called A Day in the Life, which takes its name from the famous Beatles track. Actually, it's quite common practice to use song titles for other purposes. You know, Rolf Harris used Tie Me Kangaroo Down as the title of a book about finding love in an animal hospital. And we hear Gary Glitter's after his other big hit, Two Little Boys and Two Little Toys. I shall read out an account of a typical day in the life of a well-known celebrity, but with certain key words removed. Mm-hmm. Now, the team should buzz in to suggest what might be missing. And today's celeb is Sir Cliff Richard. Mm-hmm. On tour, I rarely go to bed before blank.
Jesus.
Rhona. Oh, Dominic.
8 o'clock.
No. Rhona.
Top of stars.
Dominic.
A knuckle shuffle.
That could have been right, that could have been right, but no, it was in fact 3 a.m. I get up at about 11 a.m. and then I try to get in some blank with the pro at the nearest club.
Try to get in some tight trousers.
No, it was in fact tennis. I tried to get in some tennis with the pro at the nearest club. I'm 56 now and I've been known as the blank of pop. Rhona.
Tosser.
No, it's not. No, it's Peter
Pan.
Do you know, you got a point. Got a point. Peter Pan of Pop. Yes.
Peter Pan.
Luckily, youthful blanks are in my genes.
Bachelor boys.
No.
Youthful looks.
Youthful what? Looks. Yes, Dominic. Yes, looks. Very good. I share my house with my best friend, Bill Latham, who is also my blank. Can I just... Dominic, yes.
Devil woman. My manager. Oh,
manager.
Yeah. Oh, close. Press relations manager. Very good. Now, in the evening, Bill's girlfriend, Jill, normally does the cooking. I usually end up peeling the blanks. Dominic.
Peeling the sheets back?
No. Junior.
The love sausage.
Dominic.
Carrots.
No, but carrots is very close.
Potatoes.
Sue Barker.
Oh, no, they said potatoes. Very good. Yeah. Last thing at night, I do my blanking. Dominic.
Homework.
No.
Nails.
No.
Chanting.
Oh, you're so close now. Oh, they got it in. Praying it was. Yes, it was. And the end of that short volume brings us to the end of that round. I'm going to give 2 points to Junior and Paul, and 3 because Dominic and Rhona really tried to play that game. Well done, 3 points there. Which means at the end of round 4, Dominic and Rhona have 9, but Paul and Junior in the lead with 11. Yes. The scores are finally balanced. It's terribly tense. So we enter now our final quickfire round called What's the Question? It's a general knowledge quiz played in reverse, where it helps to be able to think backwards. Luckily, we have with us four of the most backward thinkers in the business. I wish I was joking. I have a selection of general knowledge answers to which the team should provide appropriate questions. It'll be 2 points for each one you get right. Okay. What, pray, is the question that prompted this answer? They can bounce along at 40 kilometres per hour. Paul.
What's unique about Linford Christie?
Why should you wear a decent bra in your 20s?
I was desperate. I had to.
How fast can kangaroos travel? Okay, second answer. What's the question? Toss them in the air. Dominic.
How do you make a pilot smile?
Very good.
Oh, wait. What are you doing on Shrove Tuesday with pancakes?
Frighteningly dull. You're right. What do we traditionally do with pancakes? Yes, Dominic. Next answer. It's left to mature for 12 years.
What happens to milk in a student flat?
Dominic.
Is it, what do you do with whiskey?
Dominic, you're really dreary and good at this, aren't you? How does a Scotch whiskey acquire superior taste? He's right. And you're the only one who's excited. Okay, next answer. A creature halfway between a man and a horse.
Who is Camilla Parker Bowles? What is a centaur?
Yes.
You're right!
Thank you.
What was a centaur in Greek mythology? Well done.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the answer. What's the question? Pensioners and buns. Paul.
Who always says, it's like an oven in here?
That was very good. Paul.
What's your favourite porn film?
I feel nauseous. Paul.
What do elephants eat? Is it something to do with Chelsea?
Yeah. Oh, see, after all that laughter, yeah, he comes in there with the right answer. Yes, what is Chelsea famous for?
Excuse me.
Sadly, that irritating sound means that we've come to the end of the show. And there's nothing worse than being beaten by old Father Time. Unless it's Frank Boff at the Pink Pussycat, Wardour Street. So, let's take a look at the scores. And the astonishing news is that tonight's winners are... no one. It's a dead heat. 17 points all! Nice start to the new series. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it only remains for me to reveal the true meaning of life. Hallelujah. Oh, Norwich Lesbian Choir, still in fine voice. Well, life means about 7 to 9 years with good behaviour, depending on how many people you've murdered. So, from Dominic Holland, Rhona Cameron, Paul Thorne, Junior Simpson. This is me, Graham Norton, saying goodbye. Goodbye! Goodbye!
Oh, and he says it so well as well, doesn't he? What's more, Mr. Norton will be saying hello again next Friday at the same time, 8:30, here on 5.
This might sting. Just a little.
The Legacy, a secret army of four raiding hellfire upon the phantoms, fighters, and freaks of supernature that walk the earth.
I don't believe we've had the pleasure or the pain.
Souls of black will be purged when the Legacy return to 5.
We're going to stop you.
You must know that.
You think so?
Poltergeist The Legacy, Tuesday from 9 on 5.
Stand by for heart-rending drama in Friday's film premiere. Lindsay Wagner plays a nun helping a teenage victim of assault in Sins of Silence after the break.
This is the tough part of starting a new routine. This is the easy part. Kellogg's Bran Flakes now give an even better balance of things your body needs. We call it Body Balanced Nutrition. Kellogg's Bran Flakes, a step in the right direction.
Fancy celebrating your ritzy, glitzy, extravagant side? Then indulge yourself with Müller Candy Corner. Or enjoy the side of you that craves nature and purity. The side that's sheer Müller Fruit Corner. For every side of you, there's a corner.
When it comes to her packed lunch, Georgia Lee and her mother have come to a negotiated agreement. Georgia gets a chocolate spread, and Georgia's mum spreads it on wholemeal bread. Of course, what her mum doesn't realise is that Georgia loves the bread almost as much as the spread. But then, she has been raised the Hovis way.
In your kitchen, greasy stains and watermarks are a real problem, but ordinary sprays aren't enough. Here's new Jif Kitchen Spray with its balanced active formula which dissolves grease and watermarks, and in a few wipes leaves your kitchen beautifully clean and fresh. New Jif Kitchen, the best on grease and watermarks.
He's wearing modern fabrics. Everybody's wearing modern fabrics. Everybody. They can be difficult to clean, attracting grease.
Never get that off.
And repelling water. Persil's got the answer. A special stain release system which lets water penetrate even modern